It's been a long day for me and my friends, and I'll tell you all about it and how it all ends. You come a long way from where it began, and I'll tell you all about it, you OCS man, you OCS man.
In the GPO, they fought for the air while Bone Man's mill was led by De Valera. The British bombarded with bombs and shells. The Irish were inspired with their churches ringing bells. The Oscar and the odds were vital to our cause. For this, they own a round of applause. They put their lives on the line by committing this crime. Although one failed, the other will prevail.
It's been a long day. Friends, and I'll tell you all about it and how it all ends. You come a long way from where it began, and I'll tell you all about it, you OCS man, you OCS man.
Today, 100 years have passed, forever in stone. Our history is cast as our hearts are tender. We still remember, not all fighters were of that one gender. What is this I'm saying? What am I on? I'm talking about coming them on. 134 from our great school took up arms against British rule. For this I am proud, I hope you are too. Brave boys like ours are far too few.
It's been a long day for me and my friends, and I'll tell you all about it and how it all ends. You come along.
Fighting Irish, we survived many battles, and on that sunny April's day, the Irish flag was raised. Padraic read the proclamation, and this he would say. Irish men and Irish women, in the name of God and of the dead generations from which she receives her old tradition of nationhood, Ireland, true us, summons her children to her flag and strikes for her freedom. The Irish Republic is entitled to and hereby claims the allegiance of every Irish man and Irish woman. The Republic guarantees religious and civil liberty, equal rights and equal opportunities to all its citizens, and declares its resolve to pursue the happiness and prosperity of the whole nation and all of its parts, cherishing all of the children of the nation equally, and oblivious of the differences carefully fostered by an alien government, which have divided a minority from the majority in the past. Until our arms have brought the opportune moment for the establishment of a permanent national government representative of the whole people of Ireland and elected by the suffrages of all her men and women, the provisional government hereby constituted will administer the civil and military affairs of the Republic in trust for the people.
Thank you. Easter 1916. I have met them at close of day, coming with vivid faces from counter or desk among grey 18th century houses. I have passed with a nod of the head or polite meaningless words, or have lingered a while and said polite meaningless words, and thought before I had done of a mocking tale or a jibe to please a companion around the fire at the club, being certain that they and I but lived where motley is worn. All's changed, changed utterly. A terrible beauty is born. That woman's days were spent in ignorant goodwill, her nights in argument, until her voice grew shrill. What voice more sweet than hers when, young and beautiful, she rode to harriers? This man had kept a school and rode our winged horse. This other, his helper and friend, was coming into his force. He might have won fame in the end, so sensitive his nature seemed, so daring and sweet his thought. This other man I had dreamed, a drunken, vainglorious lout. He had done most bitter wrong to some who are near my heart, yet I number him in the song. He too has resigned his part in the casual comedy. He too has been changed in his turn, transformed utterly. A terrible beauty is born. Hearts with one purpose alone, through summer and winter seem, enchanted to a stone, to trouble the living stream. The horse that comes from the road, the rider, the birds that range from cloud to tumbling cloud, minute by minute they change. A shadow of cloud on the stream changes minute by minute, a horse hoof slides on the brim, and a horse plashes within it. The long-legged moorhens dive, and hens to moorcocks call, minute by minute they live, the stones in the midst of all. Too long a sacrifice can make a stone of the heart. Oh, when may it suffice? That is heaven's part, our part, to murmur name upon name, as a mother names her child, when sleep at last has come on limbs that had run wild. What is it but nightfall? No, no, not night, but death. Was it needless death after all? For England may keep faith for all that is done and said. We know their dream enough to know they dreamed and are dead. And what if excess of love bewildered them till they died? I write it out in a verse. McDonough and McBride and Connolly and Pierce, now and in time to be, wherever green is worn, are changed, changed utterly. A terrible beauty is born.